In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, in today's gospel we see about the jealousy of the Pharisees towards Jesus Christ. So also in our life, oftentimes we are jealous about the others. So jealousy is a disease. So we must get well soon. So get well soon, we must come out of our jealousy feelings towards the others. Now to participate more worthily in this Holy Eucharist, let us acknowledge that we are sinners and we are sometimes out of jealousy cause discomfort to others in our lives. Ask the Lord for pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
The day of the Lord, the day of darkness and gloom. First reading, a reading from the prophet Joel, chapter 1, verses 13 to 15, chapter 2, 1 to 2. Priest, put on sackcloth and lament. Ministers of the altar, wail. Come, pass the night in sackcloth, you ministers of my God. For the house of God has been deprived of oblation and libation. Order a fast, proclaim a solemn assembly, elders call together. All the inhabitants of the country, to the house of the Lord your God. Cry out to the Lord, oh what a day! For the day of the Lord is near. It comes as a devastation from Shadi. Sound the trumpet in Zion. Give the alarm on my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the country tremble. For the day of the Lord is coming. Yes, it is near. Day of darkness and gloom. Day of cloud and blackness. Like the dawn they spread across the mountains. A vast and mighty host, such as never been before, such as will never be again, to the remotest ages. This is the word of the Lord. Our response shall be, the Lord will judge the world with justice. I will praise you, Lord, with all my heart. I will recount all your wonders. I will rejoice in you and be glad and sing psalm to your name, O Most High. Our response. You have checked the nations, destroyed the wicked. You have wiped out their names forever and ever. The nations have fallen in the pit which they made. Their feet caught in the snare they laid. Our response. But the Lord sits enthroned forever. He has set up his throne for judgment. He will judge the world with justice. He will judge the people with his truth. Our response. Kindly stand for gospel acclamation.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Kindly repeat. The sheep that belongs to me, listen to my voice, says the Lord. I know them and they follow me.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. Chapter 11, verses from 25 to 36. Chapter 11, verses from 15 to 26. When Jesus had cast out the devil, some of the people said, "It is through Beelzebul, the prince of devils, that he casts out devils." Others asked Jesus as a test for a sign from heaven, but knowing what they were thinking, he said to them, "Every kingdom divided against itself is heading for ruin, and a household divided against itself collapses. So too with Satan. If he is divided against himself, how can his kingdom stand? Since you assert that it is through Beelzebul that I cast out devils, now if it is through Beelzebul that I cast out devils, through whom do your own experts cast them out? Let them be your judges then. But if it is through the finger of God that I cast out devils, then know that the kingdom of God has overtaken you. So long as a strong man fully armed guards his own palace, his goods are undistributed. But when someone stronger than he is attacks and defeats him, the stronger man takes away all the weapons he relied on and shares out his spoil. He who is not with me is against me, and he who does not gather with me scatters. When an unclean spirit goes out of a man, it wanders through waterless country, looking for a place to rest. And not finding one, it says, I will go back to the home I came from. But on arrival, finding it swept and tidied, it then goes off and brings seven other spirits more wicked than itself. And they go in and set up house there, so that the man ends up by being worse than he was before. This is the gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, Oscar Wilde tells a story about the devil. This devil was once crossing the Libyan desert, where he met the number of people who were trying to torment a holy monk. And this holy saint was able to shake off their suggestions, their temptations so easily. And the devil was watching over that. After devil watched that, their failure, the devil told them, "You are too crude and too simple. Now watch me, what I will do." And the devil goes to this holy man and whispers in the ear, "Your brother has been made a bishop." The holy man says, "What? Your brother has been just made a bishop." And immediately, the peace, the serenity on the face of the holy man goes away, and the feeling of jealousy comes on his face. And the devil tells to the others, this is the way, this is the approach that you have to treat the holy men in order to make them to fall. So my dear brothers and sisters, jealousy, nobody is exempted from the feeling of jealousy. In our lives also, oftentimes we are very jealous about the others. But the thing is, when you are jealous, what are you doing? We need to question ourselves, my dear friends. Somebody says, the envious man grows lean at the success of his neighbor. The envious man grows lean at the success of his neighbor. Sometimes we see some people, how much they eat, whatever they do, but they will never become fat. Why? Because they are always jealous about the others. That is why they are very lean always. The envious man grows lean at the success of their neighbors, my dear friends. In today's gospel, we see when the mute man who started to speak again, from whom Jesus cast out the demon, there were two kinds of reactions from the people. The first reaction was from the common people. They were amazed by seeing the power of Christ. And the second reaction was from his enemies, the Pharisees. They were trying to accuse God, accuse Jesus, that you are casting out the demons with the power of the Beelzebul. You see, Jesus cast out the demon from one of the mute men. Some people were praising him. Some people were amazed by seeing the power of Christ. Whereas other people, they were trying to find the faults. They were trying to accuse him that you are casting out the demon by the help of the Beelzebul, the prince of the devils. Even in our lives also, whatever good you do, some people will be there to praise and some people will be there to find faults. So let us not be discouraged, because Jesus himself has experienced this one, the feeling of jealousy, the feeling of not accepting him. So also in our lives, if some people are there who is against us, who is always finding fault with us, let us not be discouraged. Let us try to good whatever we have to do in this world, my dear friends. Let us observe some of the points from the gospel. In the gospel of Luke, we see this man was only mute. That means he cannot speak. But whereas in the gospel of Matthew and Mark, we see the devil caused not only mute, not only dumbness, but also the devil caused blindness also. In the gospel of Luke, he was only mute. But in the gospel of Matthew and Mark, we can see this man was also caused with blindness. And who is Beelzebul? Who is Beelzebul? In Old Testament, 2 Kings chapter 1 verse 2, we see the king of Israel was injured. When the king of Israel was injured, he sent some people to the god of Ekron, who is known as Beelzebul, to inquire whether he is going to be recovered soon or not. So the Beelzebul, we also can see in the Old Testament. Beelzebul means the god of dung, the god of dungs, it seems. And the third point we can notice in the Bible is, the Bible states that the Pharisees and scribes had come down from Jerusalem to the Capernaum in order to find fault with Jesus. You know how much far from Jerusalem to Capernaum? It's almost more than 100 kilometers. So the Pharisees and the scribes traveled more than 100 kilometers just to find fault with Jesus. Just to give trouble to Jesus. You know how much they traveled? More than 100 kilometers. In our lives also sometimes, we spend our time, we spend our energy, we spend our money on spreading the evil things, on the wrong things. But my dear brothers and sisters, we never keep an effort to do the right things. We don't spend our time, our energy, our money to do the right things. Here you see the Pharisees and the scribes, they traveled 100 kilometers just to spoil the name of Jesus. In our lives also, if you are spending your time, if you are spending your energy, if you are spending your money on the wrong things to spoil the names of the other people, remember that you are also a Satan. A kochi satana, a small Satan. You also can be called a small Satan when you are using your time, your energy, your money on the wrong things to spoil the names of the others, like that of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. So four things you can notice from the gospel. The first point is, there is a spiritual battle raging with two and only two sides. One side is God, another side is devil. So there is no neutrality. Either you are on God's side or on devil's side. So there is always a battle between the God and between the devil. The second point is, Jesus Christ has authority over Satan's power. So though there is a battle, who wins the battle? Who wins the battle? Jesus always wins the battle. Hero always wins the battle over the villain. The third point is, we are either on Jesus' side or the devil's side. We have to decide. Either I am a Jesus side or I am on devil's side. We need to decide. The fourth one is, the way to be on Jesus' side is to hear the word of God and do the word of God. If you are saying, I am on Jesus' side, I don't belong to the devil, I belong to Jesus Christ, what we need to do? We have to hear the word of God and we have to do the word of God. Then you belong to Jesus and you do not belong to the Satan. And what is the difference between Satan and Jesus? Somebody says, Satan knows your name, but he calls you by your sin. God knows your sin, but he calls you by your name. So this is the difference. Satan knows your name, but he doesn't call you by name. He calls you by your sin. You are a thief, so he calls you by your sin. God knows your sin, but God calls always by your name. So this is the difference. And we know a story. Once it seems Satan and Jesus, they both were arguing that who knows the computer very well. So this is the computer world. So they both of them were arguing who knows the computer very well. And God was watching. After watching several days, he got fed up and said, see, now I am going to conduct a test for you. And afterwards I will see the result and I will judge who knows the computer among both of you. So then he conducted the test for 2 hours. Satan and Jesus, both of them were sitting before the computers and they were working on the computer for their test. So they mouse, they fax, and they send the emails. They send the emails with attachments. They download it. So whatever they know in the computer, they were doing. Just before 10 minutes of the completion of the test, suddenly there were lights and thunders in the sky and the rain started to pour down and the wind was so strong, and of course you can guess the power went off. So when the power went off, Satan was cursing and using all the vulgar language. Jesus was quiet. After 10 minutes, again the power came back. When the power came back, they restarted the computer. When they restarted the computer, Satan was yelling like anything, because whatever he has worked is gone. So Satan was saying, gone, everything is gone, all my work is waste. By the time, Jesus was printing out all the documents, whatever he has worked. And now Satan is saying, it is a cheating. Jesus is cheating. All my work is gone. And now Jesus is printing out all the work. Then God came and said, it is because Jesus saves. It is because Jesus saves. Jesus knows how to save. Satan doesn't know how to save. So this is the difference. Jesus wants you and me to be saved. And the devil does not want you and me to be saved. This is the difference, my dear friends. Now let us decide whether we are on Jesus' side or on the devil's side, my dear friends. And the jealousy, somebody said very well, blowing out someone else's candle does not make your candle shine any brighter. Blowing out someone else's candle does not make your candle shine any brighter. So let us not be jealous about the others. Finally, we all know this saying, an empty mind is the devil's workshop. But today's gospel is saying, an empty heart is the devil's favorite living place. An empty heart is the devil's favorite living place. Because we see in the Bible today, one devil went away from a person and it was looking for a place to rest, but it did not find anywhere to rest. So the devil came back. When the devil came back, the person's house was empty and it was swept nicely, cleaned very well. And the devil thought, oh my God, I did not find anywhere the rest place. Here it is very nice. And it not only came inside, it went and brought again 7 more powerful devils. And those all devils spoiled this fellow's life. My dear friends, as a Christians, by the time we received baptism and through other confessions, by receiving the holy sacraments, we have given our place to God. And if your heart is empty, be sure whatever the devil is out, again they will come back. So an empty mind is the devil's workshop. An empty heart, which is not filled with God, which is not filled with the word of God, is the favorite devil living spot. So let us be careful, my dear friends. My dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and your words may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service. Graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Holy Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might to the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifest as the church. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim: Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Thoma Bala our Archbishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. In a special way, we remember and pray for the departed souls in our families, brothers and sisters, and our beloved ones. Very specially, we pray for the departed soul of Subba Rao and Lodamma, for the departed souls of Rajan Jude Mark Matthew and his grandparents, for the departed soul of Francis John, for the departed soul of Shanti Kumar, and for the departed soul of Joseph Anthony Lawrence. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint Anthony of Padua, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to everlasting life. Partaking of the one bread and one chalice. Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord. By clapping our hands, let us express our appreciation and gratitude to the Catholic Hub TV channel. Please. Thank you. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. Go in the peace and love of Christ.